The Raw Way Show podcast with Roman Paul Clark and my nigga comedian Jay Wiley.
Not to cut you off real quick, Thrax said, "Tell Raw I need a verse too."
I still got him, bro.
He said he still got you, bro.
Hit me up. Messenger of 604.
Hey, what Thrax? What Thrax famous for? I remember I'm Ferocious. You remember that shit back in the day? I'm Ferocious.
Tell him he can get whatever he needs on that hip hop side.
That Ferocious shit. He got you, bro.
Yeah.
What are viewers talking about over there sideways?
They going through. My phone wasn't going up when I turned it. I don't know if it's because I pushed the button on
that cricket phone right there. I ain't never seen that before.
Nah, they on there.
Sideways.
Yeah, it's sideways.
That cricket phone.
Nah, that ain't a cricket, boy. Don't get.
It said right there on the side, right there. This is a cricket right here.
Yeah, it's making a noise, too.
Somebody's phone. Yeah, right. Sideways. You know. Life is what it is, and it is
what it is. Fuck you, Paul.
Fuck you, Paul. So we got a little bit of game, and you know, we're going, this is called Raw Rapid 10. And, you know, just when I say a quick question, you know, first thing to come to your mind.
Quick question, first thing to come to my mind?
Yeah. Da, 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 da. So I just made the music.
That's the theme music?
Was that dope?
They just stole it from some other game show.
He did. One. Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy.
Richard Pryor, he's God. Eddie Murphy is Jesus.
This is slow. I thought it was rapid.
I'm telling you, I was giving him a chance.
I take a deep breath and everything.
You gotta take a deep breath for that.
I thought it was gonna be fast like red, green.
Right. Well, as rapid as it can be. Put it like that.
Right.
Rapid as we can be.
Come back here.
Okay, start over real quick. Go.
Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy.
I'm gonna say Richard Pryor because he's the god of comedy, and Richard Pryor. No, Eddie Murphy is Jesus. That's the way I see him.
Eddie Murphy, Martin Lawrence.
I'm going to say Eddie Murphy because Eddie Murphy is...
Jesus?
No, he ain't Jesus. He might be David. But no, yeah, Eddie Murphy.
Kevin Hart or Dave Chappelle?
Oh, Dave Chappelle, he the GOAT.
Dave Chappelle or Richard Pryor?
Oh, that's God versus God. That's Thor versus Thor.
You feel me? It's pop.
Thor versus Thanos.
It's pop. Yeah,
Richard Pryor though, because Eddie Murphy got whatever he got from that nigga.
Right. But I said Dave Chappelle.
Oh, you said Dave Chappelle. Oh, Dave Chappelle. Yeah. I gotta go with Dave Chappelle, sorry.
Who's your GOAT?
You know what's crazy? My GOAT was Eddie Murphy. No, I'm sorry, Richard Pryor until the last 4 years of Dave Chappelle on Netflix, speaking for us real niggas against all that bullshit the world don't. You know the fuck he did.
Yeah.
He fought against it. Dave spoke for us. People want to admit that shit. Dave spoke for the real motherfuckers.
He did.
And didn't get banned for it. A black man didn't get banned.
And they tried.
They tried it. The Netflix said nope. When Netflix stood by Dave, that was powerful. That was powerful, nigga.
And he got there not even get off the question.
And he a nigga.
You can't point a finger at Dave for nothing, because no matter what you say, you can't say he homophobic. You can't, because his closest person is gay. You know, oh, he don't like Asian.
Real.
My wife is Asian. You know what I'm saying? You can't say nothing because he's close for years. Everybody.
I remember Dave way before all this shit, like on Tool Time, with Tim, what's his name, show, and all that shit. Like, I remember... He started out, like, I would always see him around white motherfuckers, like, and he was good then, but he was talking about black shit then.
Like, told our story the way he said joking and understand.
I mean, Barnes, you right, he just real.
Yeah, he dope. All right, white liquor or dark liquor?
Dark liquor. I'm drinking white liquor now because I'm mixing, which is crazy because all that Bentley syrup, I have some peach crown, and I'm with my dudes right now. I done had some, what I got?
Don Julio.
Don Julio. So whatever lady I see tonight, I feel it might be a good thing or a bad thing. I might not know. You know, I don't know.
White women or black women?
Why are you gonna do me like that? And then right now the black woman like, why the fuck he taking some on the ass? I like pussy.
That's what's
and
up.
It's pink.
That's what's up.
Everybody pink on the inside. But no, I love them black women. I do. My mama black. You know what I'm saying? I love black women. I gotta say that. I love them. I'll fuck a white woman. Y'all know that. I'm married to one. Come on, let's stop.
Okay.
Hey, but my baby mama black. You know what I'm saying? I go back and forth. You know, I don't discriminate, motherfuckers.
Yeah, you can't. Because it's all nice.
It's all pink on this side.
If you were given a chance to go on a on a big comedy tour, but wasn't going to be paid, would you still do it?
A big comedy tour.
But you wasn't going to be paid.
But I wouldn't be paid, but I still do it. And why? Hell yeah. If it's a big comedy tour, I mean, I'm about to get exposure. And in this new world, this new fucking world of exposure, this new world is about exposure. Why you think bitches is half naked when they go outside to the grocery store?
It's about what you learn.
And how much I would learn. Yeah, that's a great ass point. The key to anything, the most valuable thing to anything is what you learn from it. Not even what you got financially, because what you learn from it can benefit you financially later.
If you hear Kevin Hart somewhere testing on the phone with somebody and shit, because his agent is doing this and this and this, the industry, fuck, you just hearing that and he gonna talk to you about it, just look out for it, right? These snake ass motherfuckers, it's snakes everywhere.
I like what you said, because you gotta respect the dudes in front of you. Like, I made a post the other day, I gave Dick Dickerson, Rhoda Realist, a couple other comedians a shout out. That when I first got in the game, they taught me. They told me what to do, what not to do.
That's my guy, Rhoda Realist, what's up?
Rhoda Realist, the realist.
That's my guy.
This is how I knew I made it. Forget the TK Hickman shit. I knew I made it because Rhoda Realist is my feature act when I was the headliner last week. You know what I'm saying? You know how many times he's been a headliner and I was the feature act, but I was just on the show, happy to be there. I was on the show with Ro, nigga. I was a headliner.
I was trying to go with Ro. We were supposed to go to Lima.
Ro should be the star
by now. Yeah, we supposed to be going to Lima one time. I was gonna go with him, follow him to the show and shit. I was gonna go with him or in the car with him or whatever vehicle with him.
Right.
But it didn't get to happen. But that's my guy. Big up, bro. So shit. Browns or Bengals?
What makes me laugh at this? I wish I had more views right now, because the Browns fans hate me. I'm from Cleveland. And I'm only a Browns fan when they fucking win it. Motherfucker.
Who need you?
Because I'm free. I'm not a slave. You're not going to hurt my fucking feelings. I'm 48. You're going to hurt my feelings for 40 fucking years. I'm glad he fucking brought this up. I'm about to go on a rant real quick. Seriously.
Go ahead.
I'm about to go on a rant. Okay. I was a dedicated Browns fan. Okay? Did y'all see the loss they had to the Jets the other day?
That was
2 weeks ago? They was up by 13 with 2 minutes left in the game? Okay, 2002 is when I stopped being a Browns fan. You know why? Same fucking scenario. They play Chicago Bears. Jay Cutler is the quarterback. Derek Alexander is our quarterback. We're up by 14 with 2 minutes to go. I go get in the shower and post on social media, the Browns has won. Good night, motherfuckers.
You get a battle out.
I go take a shower for 10 minutes.
Oh,
it was only 2 minutes left, but I took a shower for 10 minutes. It was 2 minutes left, you motherfuckers. 2 minutes! I took a shower for 10.
Oh,
when I get out the shower, the game is still on. I'm in my fucking towel. I walk to the living room. And I'm like, what a game still on? Why do I still hear them saying the Cleveland Browns when I've been in the shower for 10 minutes? That was a long ass commercial. When I get in my living room, I took a deep breath just now. I just fucking felt that. When I walk in my fucking living room, Derek Alexander threw a fucking interception, a pick six for a touchdown, and we lost 21-14. And we were up by 14 with 2 minutes left. I dropped to the ground with my towel on bucket fucking naked and cried like a bitch. That was the last time I was a Browns fan. Ever since then, I say, fuck the Browns. I'm only going to cheer for them when they win. Period. I'm supposed to live to be 90. Because I was a Browns fan, I'm going to die at 60, you motherfuckers. The stress is ridiculous. And I'm serious right now. I'm so serious, I got my hands.
That sounds, they hurt you bad, bro.
This is therapy right now. I don't want to talk about this.
Guys, here we
are. I'm not done. Time out. I'm sorry, real quick. They repeated that shit. They repeated that shit with the Jets. I'm not done. Listen, Brown fans, when he missed that field goal, the extra point to put y'all up by 14. Real Brown fan knew we was gonna lose that game. That's how I'm a Brown fan, I become Notre Dame. I don't know what the fuck they about to do. You know what I'm saying? When we missed that extra point, y'all see that game? When I picked the Jets.
I see.
When they missed that extra fucking point, I said they're gonna lose. And they fucking lost.
I do the Browns, the Bengals, and the Buckeyes. I just keep it all right.
Definitely a Bengal.
My that shit hurt my Bengals because my God, I got off my chest. Thanks for listening.
Because I used to, me and my dad used to go to Bengals games and shit. Watch the Bengals and shit. I'd be like, Dad.
Y'all went to the Super
they
Bowl.
They about to lose.
Fuck that. Y'all went to the Super Bowl last year.
We did.
Out of nowhere.
And they stacked, like I keep telling them, they stacked still big.
What y'all did last year was like being a virgin in high school and you fucked the baddest bitch on prom night out of nowhere. Like, you didn't go with her. She pulled you in the room and sucked you off in the bathroom. Yeah. What y'all did last year?
I don't like high school.
What y'all did? He's a
prom night. All
right. What y'all did last year, ridiculous.
It was. And that's why I told them they still playing good. They just didn't make it happen. But they won today, though. They looked good today. Did they thing today. Won today. And, you know, I'm happy with it. It's a morale. It's morale booster.
They knocked out Joe Glass.
Still, you knocked Joe Glass out.
That's why it hurts Brown fans so bad. It's like, you got beat up by Joe Glass. Come on. Now, the Jets. I hated the Jets every since they had Chad Pennington.
I never even liked it. I never even knew who nobody was on the Jets.
I was so racist towards him. You fucking ginger.
You call him a ginger. That's a racist shit. You call him a ginger.
It wasn't nothing else I could come up with. He was already doing this shit.
Wrong.
All that red hair and shit. Dye that shit. You play that.
So, y'all hear about the nursing home the nurse home that brought strippers in for vets, for some veterans, to try to get them up and up and moving around and shit.
I didn't see it.
Try to get a rise.
Get a rise out of them.
Was it young strippers or was it strippers their age or whatever? Like,
I didn't see the strippers.
It was young strippers.
Young babies.
The paperwork that you got to sign for that shit.
They had strippers at a
nursing home.
For veterans. I'm let you know right now, all veterans,
they've been trying to
kill them with their dicks. If they shit can get up, you know what I'm saying? Come on now. If I'm saluting.
I'm definitely going to salute.
Matter of fact, the idea that you have, but what you just said, that's a great idea. Mm-hmm. If I'm in a nursing home, I want strippers to come once a month.
That would be dope.
If I'm in a nursing home, I know when I get that age, man, I have money.
Because now
I'm paying for that. That's part of the package. I want bitches
and these visiting me at 6:30, right? they coming at 6:30, right?
Come early.
Sleep at 8:00.
No, sleep at 8:30. Come early, okay?
With the paper, you gotta sign out.
My nursing home, give me some bitches. Some young bitches. They're gonna be disgusting because I'm going to be out. I don't give a fuck.
Oh shit,
yeah, my 401k is going towards my bitches.
Mr.
Clark. My 401k is for my bitches, alright? Right now, right now I got 120,000 in my 401k. That's a lot of bitches.
Mr. Rock don't touch your Philly and shit. Oh,
right. He got problems.
Mr. Clark, And that man keep calling himself Raw Wavy.
Right.
I went to school with your friend.
Right. I know your auntie.
Just like a.
You know, pumpy old man and shit. Bitch, anybody ask you to ask me about that, bitch? Give me another one.
high five like this. That's how I got that high five from chicken and shit.
Oh, shit, y'all.
Oh, man. Can't talk to me.
This is
different. Oh, Tiffany, I ain't gonna have no worms, goddammit. Ain't no worms in this.
That's what I'm saying. All the chicks think a nigga a little older. He ain't
got right, trick old nigga. We don't get old too, goddammit. If you don't get old, you
that's
get
middle age. That's not old.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, come on now.
I mean, I'm going through a midlife crisis right now because all I want is cocaine and strippers. I ain't never did cocaine. And I want a convertible.
But that party gotta be, that'll be a crazy party. Motherfucking cocaine strippers.
Cocaine strippers. That's a party.
And whiskey.
And chlamydia pills.
And chlamydia pills.
And pork out.
That's wild.
Man. J-Dub, Jay Wiley, my nigga.
My nigga Lonnie Barnes. We went to high school together 20 years ago, man. We ain't talked in 30 years. Love you like a brother, bro.
We are happy that you came through to kick it with us today. We are ecstatic.
Hey, this is a legend right here, man. This is the motherfucking legend right here, bro.
Broadway,
Jordan. Broadway, Jordan.
13, Instagram. Or Broadway, just Google that nigga.
Just Google that nigga. It's the story behind that.
Yeah.
My man right here.
Yep.
Hey, he a future comedian. He even know. We about to talk about this. Right. So make some shit happen. We got a producer. There's always a black man behind the scene that don't get
Ghost.
The props. That don't get the props they should get. You know
Ghost,
what I'm saying?
There's no us.
And I'm Jay Wiley, y'all.
And we just want to show some love, man. You came to kick it with us, and we appreciate you, bro.
Appreciate you, man. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
I was a diva tonight too. I said, these niggas late. Fuck these niggas. Let me go get a drink.
Yeah.
But I'm glad like a real nigga.
Yeah, like it's supposed to be. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all be good.
So this has been the Rawway Show podcast with Rawway and Paul Clark and our special guest, Jay Wiley, comedian extraordinaire. Holla back at it. I'm sorry I said your name for you because I know you do your shit on your own. But maybe we can pay a bill and then you can say goodbye.
That'll work right there because I was looking for this one thing, but I got a taste with some greens. I want something different. I mean, some chicken from our famous kitchen. When they know ingredients, mince and lettuce and all the brisket.
Brisket.
I like my cornbread, this thick.
This
pick up
thick.
The phone, come get this.
Come get
they got
this.
The biggest sandwiches. Ha, ha. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Is that macaroni and cheese up? Is that macaroni and cheese up? Is that macaroni and cheese up? Yup.
Our famous kitchen. Holler at us. We got you. Yeah. 614-556-2174. Life should be relaxing, but it's not. Sometimes we have to create our own enjoyment with many different creme velour flavors, such as blackberry plum, strawberry rose, peach, and pomegranate mango. Also, don't forget lemon haze and berry beautiful. Kick up your feet and relax. Enjoy the taste. Creme velour, draped imperial grapes. Creme velour, my lord. And this is your boy, Rawway, a.k.a. the big homie.
And Paul Clark, that born and raised Lincoln Parker.
And the homeboy,
Jay Wiley. Appreciate y'all.
And my nigga from behind the camera, Playboy the Ghost.
Yep.
We off this bitch. See y'all next time. I'm on it.